Hi, it's Roberto Mickey with your COVID-19 update for August 16th, 2020. New deaths in Florida were only 107. Hopefully this is a sign of a good new trend. Overall cases in Florida are down at 3,899, and Miami-Dade is also down at 937. Overall admissions to the hospitals across Miami-Dade County are down at 1,310. And this is great news, but I want to show you some other graphs that I've made. This graph demonstrates the number of patients that are admitted to hospitals in Miami-Dade County. And you can see the markings for reopening and reclosure of the economy here in South Florida. The horizontal line basically represents a 3-week period, so you can see visually where the 3-week mark is after each of those key moments. Not surprisingly, from this graph, you can see that about 3 weeks after the reopening, we see a dramatic increase in the number of admissions. And 3 weeks after the reclosure, you see a dramatic drop in the number of admissions countywide. I made another graph with the data from Jackson Health, and basically it shows almost the same identical curves, with the reopening showing an increase and with the reclosure a dramatic drop. This graph tries to demonstrate what would have happened had we not closed the economy. The line represents the curve that we were on prior to closure of the economy, and basically it shows that we would have hit about 4,000 admissions had we continued on a linear growth and not an exponential growth, at around 4,000 patients, which would have been right about now. This doesn't sound like a lot of patients, but we only have about 6,000 beds here in Miami-Dade County, so we would have hit close to 2/3 of our limit, and this is assuming that we had linear growth and not exponential growth. This graph basically shows how lucky we were and what a good decision the county officials made in closing the economy again. I'm gonna make a strong argument that our government, including the federal, state, and the county level, should be looking at hospital admissions and not the number of cases or the number of deaths, because this data tells us the true impact of anything that we're doing, including opening or closing the economy. Now, granted, it does take 3 weeks to see the results of those changes, but it's a good barometer and will help us make good decisions in the future. Also, if we have a lot of positive tests, but most of them are asymptomatic and it's not stressing our system, then we don't really care. What we care about are the patients that come in and get admitted to the hospital that are stressing the healthcare system. Admissions are a true measure of the impact of the disease going on in the community, because you can't hide if you're sick. So I would argue that you could use the admissions to extrapolate the number of patients that are actually being infected in the community as well. I'll get off my soapbox now. And well, West Kendall Baptist Hospital, once again, is resuming elective inpatient cases on August 17, 2020. We announced that previously. And Mercy Hospital is also restarting elective inpatient cases on August 17, 2020. Admissions overall in the county were only 65 patients. Discharges, once again, outpaced admissions, 81 to 65. And there are 567 available ventilators in Miami-Dade County. Once again, here's the data that you can look at yourself on the website at miamidade.gov. Everyone out there, be safe, wear a mask, practice social distancing. And if you like this video, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and stay up to date.